Let's begin in Austin, though, this morning, and a conservative state senator who is behind some of the most controversial bills of this special session. State Rep. Brian Hughes, a Republican from Mineola in East Texas, who spoke to us from the Capitol. Senator Hughes, welcome back to the program. You once again are carrying several big bills in the special session here. Let's take these individually. The first is changes to election law. Democrats in the House effectively killed this during the special session, but not all Republicans were on board with it in the chamber down the hall there. How will this special session version be different from what we saw before?
It's interesting. The bill is not, the provisions of the bill are not aimed at voters who are trying to cheat. They're aimed at vote harvesters and people trying to coerce voters and steal their votes and unduly influence their vote. I mean, the voters are trying to get it right. We want to make sure they're able to cast a ballot fairly and cleanly, and they know the ballot's going to be counted accurately. So it's a good bill, and we're optimistic it's going to pass.
A lot of pushback, though, early on was from Republicans about the Sunday morning changes that were in the Senate bill. Has that been changed in this special session bill?
Jason, I'm glad you asked that. So Senate Bill 1 that I filed says you can do not 5 but 6 hours of Sunday voting. You have to do 6 hours anytime between 6 a.m. and 9 p.m. So they can do afternoon, morning, whenever they want to do it.
Senator, what else is different in this bill than you had previously filed?
So there were some provisions in the original bill about poll watchers using cameras, and that got kind of tedious. We weren't sure how that would work practically, so that's out. What we do have, which makes sense, is cameras, a live stream camera in the central counting room. Whenever those ballots are brought in, they're going to be on camera the whole time. Also, the signature process, where they're checking to compare the signatures on those applications for ballot by mail and on the envelopes to make sure they're accurate, that's going to be recorded. You can't see the signature, but you can see who's in there and see that it's being done fairly. So those are some changes that have been made. Again, it's about making sure the process works and making sure it works fairly.
This bill had a hearing on Saturday in the Senate, but when do you expect it might go to the Senate floor for a full vote?
We expect to have that on the floor on Tuesday. We'll have a robust debate. Everyone will have their say. We're going to listen. The bill's going to be debated. We anticipate being on the Senate floor on Tuesday.
You are also once again trying to get a bill passed to punish social media companies who kick off users that violate the rules. You tried this 2 years ago. It didn't pass. You tried it in the last session that ended at the end of May. It didn't pass then, too. And the same as voting, Republicans weren't really on board with this in the House. How is this going to be different? What makes you think it might pass this time?
No, the bill the Senate passed in the regular session, this is going to look a whole lot like it. Our bill from the last session, 2019, was different. This one looks at the federal law, looks at the federal court rulings. You may have seen that Florida bill just got struck down. This bill is different. We believe this bill will get past the federal courts and will protect Texans' free speech online. We're very optimistic about it.
Senator, how concerned are you that Democrats could walk out of either chamber and break quorum and shut this whole thing down again?
Well, they certainly can. We saw that happen at the end of the last session. As you know, the rules allow the lieutenant governor and the speaker of the House to put a call on the House and the Senate. When they do that, they lock the doors and they send the DPS to arrest the absent members. I don't think we get cuffed or anything, but they bring the members back to preserve a quorum, to restore and preserve a quorum. I don't think that'll be necessary, but it's in the Constitution, it's in the rules, it's there for a reason. Each one of us took an oath. We raised our right hand and swore an oath. We have a job to do, and that means being here, debating, voting. Win or lose, we're here and we vote, and we do our jobs for the people of Texas.
Senator Hughes, we appreciate the time.
Thanks for having me, Jason.